Alright, so there's only 5 hours until endgame, and I'm currently working on the vlog. So the vlog that you're watching right now is what I'm currently editing, so that it comes out tomorrow after I finish watching endgame. 5 hours left, I'm still excited, but still like, oh, this is gonna be the end, it's gonna be the end. But, vlog first. Okay, it is 9:15. And we're about to go meet Aaron and Jasmine to go watch the movie. I have my shield, I have my coat, and I have Jasmine and Aaron. Yay! Are you guys ready?
Yes. Yes and no.
Yes. Mercedes came in back like yesterday, she was like just dead.
Actually.
Like she was like curled in a little ball in her bed for like 10 minutes.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Spoilers.
Yeah.
Oh, no spoilers. Ah!
So we're in the car heading toward the theater, and we're a little bit early, but I'm gonna tell you guys a story as well while I'm here. So a long time ago, when I was cosplaying, well, I'm still cosplaying now, but a long time ago, I was doing this thing where I bought a shield off of eBay, and the shield was made by a man who actually made the shields for Universal Studio. So it was actually professionally made. The only thing is I had to give it its handles as well as its colors. And so the thing was that it was really expensive for me to ship it to me. So I shipped it over to Sarah instead. And then we finished it over at her house before the convention. And then after the convention, like, the shield's really big. It was like 27 inches in diameter. And it's an accurate screen size. And like, I was like, okay, I can't bring this with me on the plane because I don't have my luggage. It's not big enough to fit it. So I left it with Sarah. And then eventually, like a couple of months later, like, I had to like scrounge up some cash. And then I was like, well, I have this shield that I don't have access to because it's at Sarah's house. So we decided to sell it on Letgo. And we put it up on Letgo and this guy picked it up. And then she went to Vegas to meet him because she was out in California at the time. And she went to Vegas and she went to go meet the guy. And they're talking about, you know, like Marvel stuff because, you know, he's buying a shield, so obviously he's a Marvel fan. And then he's like, oh yeah, like we'll probably like, you know, finish it up a little bit more because, you know, there's some paint shipping from like the convention. And they're like, okay, yeah. And then she's like, yeah, he's like, we'll finish it up because when we finished filming, Chris never got his. And she's like, what? And the guy's like, oh, I didn't tell you. I work for a company that creates some of the props for the Marvel movies. But the problem is that we never gave Chris his own shield. So this shield is actually going to go to Chris after we finish it. So my shield is currently in the possession of Chris Evans. He has my shield. So there's my story. It's in the dark, but I hope you enjoyed that story. Yeah. And if you're wondering how we knew that the guy actually knew Chris Evans, well, he pulled up a photo on his phone and it was like, here's Chris Evans and me at a party we went to together. And there's a picture of him with Chris Evans, which I have in my phone. And so that's how we knew he knew him, because it wasn't at a random like convention or thing. It was actually at like a local house. So it wasn't just like random street person finding Chris. It was actually like at some like an event. So that's how we know. That's how we know the guy knew Chris Evans, because he gave us a picture of him with Chris Evans. So yeah, it's kind of fun to know that the captain has my shield. But you know what? Weird though, in interviews, he says that he has many shields at home, like that they gave him. So I don't know if that's what to believe.
Have a lot of shields now.
He probably does have now shields now, but that was back during after Avengers 1 that I gave that shield went to him. So yeah, my shield's gone. But it's okay. I have a second shield. I have a second shield that's underneath my bed, which kind of sucks because I should open that shield up. Okay, so we're at WEM. Aaron's over there. We're gonna come in. See, here, hold this. I have my coat.
Oh, wait, yeah. Wait, is it? Oh, there you go.
I have my shield, I have my coat.
Yeah!
I'm such a dork right now. Look how crazy Europa board is. It looks so pretty. Ba 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 ba. Were you guys excited? Were you excited? Are you excited? Are you excited? We were going to get McDonald's, but then the McDonald's was probably closed, right? So anyways, we're going to go all the way over to the other side and we're going to do the thing. But we're going to go up to theaters, and I can't film the theaters obviously because it's like, you know, it's a theater. So we're just going to go up the stairs, get our tickets, and then we're just going to chill for an hour.
What is that?
So, we've a lot of time to waste, and we've got some toys walking around. I didn't know this is new. Is this new?
Look at this.
Okay, so any predictions about the movie?
Everyone dies.
Everyone dies? Again?
Again.
Yeah, any predictions? Everyone dies. Does everyone just die?
Yeah.
Okay. I think I'm gonna bet that the first three die. Thor, Cap, and Iron Man. That's my guess.
I feel like Tony and Cap die, not Thor.
I think Thor's gonna die. They're all gonna die. It's all gonna happen. It's worth fuck.
Someone obviously sacrifices himself.
Yes, yes. Okay, from here on in, we're going up to theater, so I'm gonna be able to film. So, are you guys ready?
You guys ready?
Yes.
We survived! Oh my god. Fucking. I have unlost the words. I'm actually at a loss for words. That fucking movie. I can't even. That was a beautiful movie. That was actually beautiful. Did you guys cry? I cried.
I
cried a little bit. Everyone cried. There was a couple times where it's like, you have to cry, but like, no, you can't cry because you have to like hold it back to watch what's going on. I can't not see what's going on. Don't cry.
I didn't have time to wipe off my tears.
Oh my god.
I just kept crying while watching.
There's so many. If you have been watching the movies for 10 years, you will fucking, you just, fuck, this will be the best thing of your life. Oh my god, people in the crowd, like that was, can we go out this way? Yeah, yeah. People in the crowd, like, they were just, I think it was so different from Endgame because everyone was so quiet because no one wanted to say anything because they didn't want to miss any moment of it. It was just so, so powerful.
Different.
Yeah.
No annoying audience.
Oh, there was, oh my god, there
I
was.
I mean, there was the fucking lady kicking my chair with us.
Oh,
yeah. I saw that.
Different. I kept moving, every time she kick it, like, trying to guilt trip her, but she kept fucking kicking. Like,
oh my goodness. Kick.
Why do you need that much leg room? She stood up, she was like close to 5 feet, like, makes sense.
Oh my goodness. Oh my god, that was like the most, yeah, that was it. That was the best movie I've ever seen in my life. what else? I'm gonna keep the, whoop, can you hold this for a sec? Yeah? For the first time ever, I'm keeping these guys, because we never keep these because these are stupid, but but because it's a Marvel movie at the end, so we're keeping these ones. Yeah, if you guys get the chance to see it, please do. See it in theaters, do not miss out. If you have to catch up, do it. I'm talking to you, Larissa. If you have to keep up, watch it out, okay? All right. Okay, that was it. That was history making. April 2018. Hope you guys enjoy the vlog. I'll come up more vlogs because that fucking movie gave me so much adrenaline. I just want to make things and move forward. That's what we do. We move forward. Okay. So Endgame has happened, and we finally watched it. Yeah, it was something else. I just want to say thank you to Marvel and all the work that everyone's put into these movies. They've got me through a lot in the last couple of years, and I really appreciate the fact that we can have this moment where everything comes to a point of culmination. I mean, that movie was so perfect. Like, look, Jasmine barely even ate any of popcorn. Look, she shouldn't eat this much of it because she was so enamored with it. And I think I am too. I was just mentally... That movie It's a mental exhaustion on your brain, but that was it. That was the end of the 10 years. So, thank you, Marble. Thank you very much for all the things you've taught us in the last 10 years. Here's to another 10.